Hey everyone, I did a little shopping yesterday. I went to the Books a Millions. I got a couple of magazines and they're sewing and crochet. And then today, my husband and I, we went to lunch downtown and we saw that there was a new craft shop. So he asked me if I'd like to go in there, and I did, and I found a couple of things, and then I went to the Habitat for Humanity. So I'm going to go ahead and get started. This is from the new craft shop. She didn't have a lot of sewing stuff in there and crochet. That's what I'm interested in. And so she asked me what I'm interested in. I told her. So she's planning on getting more things in, things that I would like to have. But anyhow, she got a couple of things that she had a couple of things that I purchased. And so I got some ribbons. These are 5/8 and inches wide, and they're 4 feet long. So I got this real pretty one. I love the butterfly and the flowers on this, and the purple. I mean, that purple really stood out to me. Okay, to get back to my haul, here's a really cute ribbon. What is it? A caterpillar. Really cute. I thought that was adorable. Oh, look at that. It says "You bug me" on the front of it. That's cute. And these were $2.50 each. Okay. And then I got another ribbon, and this one was open, but she says it has not been cut on or anything. She also sells ribbons by the feet also. And I wanted the whole thing. So anyhow, there you go. Isn't that cute? I really like that's like the purple one. But the blue really stood out to me also, like the purple did. And I saw this, and I've never seen this before, and I thought, well, you know what? I could probably make some little bracelets or something for my grandchildren. And so these are snaps, and it's called Twill Snaps. Well, it's for scrapbooking. Then I got this. This is called Scrapper's Rings. There's 8 pieces. It has a little hole in it. I'm not really sure what scrappers would use this with. It says embellish with charms and ribbons. And I thought, well, you know, I could probably come up with some a kind of an idea. Oh, those snaps were $2, by the way. And these rings are $2. But anyhow, they're in different colors. You get a yellow. And that's what it looks like. It's not really that wide. It's about 1 inch in diameter. So you get a yellow, and you get a green. And they do, I guess they do. Yeah, see, they do come apart like that, and then you snap it back together. And then you get a blue. And then you get purple, and you get two of each color. Okay, I'm going to do the Books a Millions. Millions, right? No, million. I don't know why I want to put an S on the end of it. Now, I went a little crazy on these magazines. They're from the UK, from England. And I like their magazines better than I like the American magazines, because they're bigger. You get more things to make, because the American magazines, they have too many advertisements. The UK magazines do not. So this one is called Love Crocheting. And it has a lot of cute things in here that I'm going to enjoy making. And I'm going to show you what I have found that I know I'm going to enjoy making. Now, in the front of the magazine, I mean, this magazine cost me $11.50. But it is worth it, because I checked out the American magazines yesterday also, and they were like $7, and they don't have a lot of things you can make. But like on the front page, it says welcome. So I think that's from the editor. Yeah, it's from the editor, so it says welcome. And then on the other page, it has all the different things that you can make. Okay, these are so cute. These are little penguins. Look at that. Isn't that cute? So I think I want to make those. Okay, this is really cute. These are little baby girl shoes. Oh, now who doesn't like owls? Look at that. This is cute. This is a frog. Okay, here's something nice that I think I might want to try. It's called Cool to Be Square. It's a granny chic or psychedelic stripe pillow. Isn't that pretty? I like that. Here, let me open it all the way and you can see the other pillow. Here's another pillow. It's called In a Spin. Cushioned by Tracy Todd Hunter makes a fun addition to your home. And that is so pretty. I like that. It's got a button in the middle of it. So there's a lot in here that I want to make. This one is called Sweet Dreams. Oh, well, it's one of those dream catchers. So it's a crocheted dream catcher. And then this is a vintage lace flower you can put in your hair. Real dainty looking. I like things like that. And see, it gives you step-by-step instructions with pictures and all too. It's like a brooch type thing. A lapel pin is what it's called. Oh, now this I'm definitely going to make. It's called a flower garden. It's a handbag. You can use as a well, it's a bag. You can use as a handbag or a grocery bag, whatever you want to use it for. Or shopping bag is what I meant. Isn't that pretty? So I definitely want to make that. This is something cute, but this is not for me. It's a Chantilly cream. What did they call it? What do they call this thing? Shrug. It's a crocheted shrug. And I would never make that for myself. This right here is called Bunny Hop, introducing the softest, cutest, plumpest bunny on the block. That is so cute. I think I might make that. Oh, I didn't see this. This is a coin purse. I definitely want to make the coin purse, but I need to find the closure. Now, here's one of those Make-A-Wish ponies. My youngest granddaughter used to love these things. I don't know if she still does or not. But that is so cute. I know it's probably kind of hard to see. I don't know some better pictures of it. See? And then here's one right here. Well, they're the banner things. And I'm thinking about making those for my sewing room to decorate it up. Now, this is cute. This is one of those cozy things for your cup. And here's a better picture of it without her hand on it. Isn't that cute? I like the pig. I think it's adorable. Now this is adorable too. There, I told you there's a lot in here I like. Now this is an applique if you're going to make an apron, and you can crochet this and use it as applique, or you can use it as an applique on placemats or a coaster. So anyhow, that's what it is. And let me see if I can find a, well, here's a picture of the apron with the and what it is, it's bacon, eggs, sausage, it looks like toast, and it looks like a couple of tomatoes. Okay, here we go. Here's the coasters. See the coasters right there? And then I'm trying to see if I can find the place. All right, now there's the placemats right there. One of those teapot cozy things. And I want to make this. I collect teapots. So I definitely want to make that. This is cute. It's called Feline Lucky. And they're little Chinese cats. See, isn't that cute? And I guess that's a bowl of food or something next to them. This is a ripple shawl, which I think is real pretty, and I might make that for myself. Here's another shopping bag, which I don't know if I would like all those holes or not. I mean, it'd probably be okay for your produce or something like that. Here's another pillow cover. It's called Flower Power. I think that's really pretty. I like that. So, magazine. You're not going to believe this. The sewing magazine was $20, but it came with three patterns also. And this is from 1957, and I love those dresses. I like the short sleeve one a lot better than I do the three quarter. But I love making stuff like this. I love the full skirts. I love the way that they used to dress back in the 40s and the 50s and the 60s. And this one's from 1947. I'm not too sure about this. Okay, now this dress right here is called the Sweetheart Dress from the 50s. And it's this pattern right here. So this is what it looks like if when it's already made up. I really like that dress, so I'm definitely going to be making that for myself. Another style of that, is it the same dress? No, it's called, wait a minute, Take a Trip Down Petticoat Lane. Oh, to show you how to make the petticoat to go underneath these dresses. Okay, now here's the dress from 1947, and I'm not that crazy about it, the way that it looks. See, I'm not real, I don't think I'm going to be making that. I want to make that swimsuit right there. I like that swimsuit. It's from the 50s. I want to make that swimsuit. A tulip dress. This is a tulip dress. But here, I'm definitely going to make this dress. This is called a spotty frock. And there it is right there. And I got the pattern to go with it. So I'm definitely going to make that. And it gives you, and it tells you step by step in the magazine how to make this dress. A couple of magazines, and they're craft, well, they're sewing and crochet. And then today, my husband and I, we went to lunch downtown, and we saw that there was a new craft shop. So he asked me if I'd like to go in there, and I did, and I found a couple of things, and then I went to the Habitat for Humanity. So I'm going to go ahead and get started. This is from the new craft shop. She didn't have a lot of sewing stuff in there and crochet. That's what I'm interested in. And so she asked me what I'm interested in. I told her. So she's planning on getting more things in, things that I would like to have. But anyhow, she got a couple of things that she had a couple of things that I purchased. And so I got some ribbons. These are 5/8 and inches wide, and they're 4 feet long. So I got this real pretty one. I love the butterfly and the flowers on this, and the purple. I mean, that purple really stood out to me. She was mainly set crochet doilies or whatever with. She sold those either by the feet or the yard, and I says, well, how about if I want to buy the whole thing? So she says that she would have to do a special order. So she didn't have the hooks, and she didn't have knitting needles and that kind of thing, but she just got started, so she says that she's in the process of getting more things in. Okay, to get back to my haul, here's a really cute ribbon. What is it? A caterpillar. Really cute. I thought that was adorable. Oh, look at that. It says "You bug me" on the front of it. That's cute. And these were $2.50 each, and which is a little pricey, but I've never seen anything like this before. So I said, well, why not? I'll give her my business. She's just starting out, and I will support downtown businesses because that's where she was. She was downtown. I love going downtown because there's shops in every building, all kinds of different shops. So I like to walk. It's a circle type downtown, and there's a park in the middle of it. Anyhow, I like to walk around and check out all these shops and whatever. Anyhow, I keep getting distracted, don't I? Anyhow, this is 5/8 wide and 4 feet long also, but I thought it was really cute. Okay, and then I got another ribbon, and this one was open, but she says it has not been cut on or anything. She also sells ribbons by the feet also. And I wanted the whole thing. So anyhow, there you go. Isn't that cute? I really like, that's like the purple one, but the blue really stood out to me also, like the purple did. And I saw this, and I've never seen this before, and I thought, well, you know what? I could probably make some little bracelets or something for my grandchildren. And so these are snaps, and it's called Twill Snaps. Well, it's for scrapbooking, and I'm not really sure how you would use it on in scrapbooking, but it says simply thread ribbon or paper through the snap, adhere to your page, and snap it together. It says it's the perfect way to close a mini book or album, and it's available in 18 different color themes. It says that it coordinates to the Collections line, Collections. But I thought they were really cute. She only had one pack. She didn't have the 18 different selections. So I thought that was really cute. So I'm anxious to see what I can do with that. Maybe I'll use one of these ribbons and try it out. I thought about my grandchildren when I saw that. Then I got this. This is called Scrapper's Rings. There's 8 pieces. It has a little hole in it. I'm not really sure what scrappers would use this with. It says embellish with charms and ribbons. And I thought, well, you know, I could probably come up with some a kind of an idea. Oh, those snaps were $2, by the way, and these rings are $2. But anyhow, they're in different colors. You get a yellow, and that's what it looks like. Now, it's not really that wide. It's about 1 inch in diameter. So you get a yellow. And you get a green. And they do, I guess they do. Yeah, see, they do come apart like that. And then you snap it back together. And then you get a blue. And then you get purple. And you get two of each color. So that's what I got at the new craft shop. We have a fabric store here, but they're mainly toward quilting, and I don't quilt. I've tried, well, I didn't, well, maybe I've tried like small quilting jobs, but I'm just not into it. If I want to make a handbag and it calls for quilting, I'll go get the fabric that's already quilted. I don't like to fool with it. Okay, I'm going to do the Books a Millions. Millions, right? No, million. I don't know why I want to put an S on the end of it. Now, I went a little crazy on these magazines. They're from the UK, from England. And I like their magazines better than I like the American magazines, because they're bigger, you get more things to make, because the American magazines, they have too many advertisements. The UK magazines do not. So this one is called Love Crocheting. And it has a lot of cute.